into a queue. So when you put them into a queue, it is really we are getting it from the multi-dimensional database. If I design another cube in the project, can I borrow those dimensions? Yes. That's a test type of question. Okay? See, don't forget, database dimensions are the base. They can be used anywhere. They can be used anywhere in any number of cubes. In fact, if there is a dimension, it's nothing but an XML file, am I right?
Yeah.
So even if you've designed it elsewhere, you can import into any project, even if it is not part of the project. Okay? I'm going to wait a few more minutes because what we are going to talk today is going to be exactly how it is going to be in your midterm, but it will be based on a different database, so you will have to learn to do it. But I'll show you step by step today. Exactly the same thing will be in your final, but final will have some more advanced features. Let me ask you another question. When you create a cube or a project containing cubes and dimensions and other things, and you deploy it, what are, and let's say I want to wipe out everything. Whatever I have done, I want to wipe out everything. So what are the three areas that I have to look into to trace, to wipe out the entire trace?
It's a database.
First we have to go to multi-dimensional database.
Yeah.
Because deployment has placed it in multi-dimensional database, am I right?
Yeah.
Guys, I have received an email from Jack that if anybody misses any class, I have to let him know. I have an email.
Yeah.
So please do not miss the class. I am not going to let him know. If you are sick once, I will make an allowance for that. Any of us can fall sick. But if you miss more than once, I have no choice but I have to inform you. Okay?
Yeah.
Because this is my direction. But if you are sick one day and you miss it, that's fine. Any of us can become sick. But you must send me an email, okay? Okay, so what are the three areas? First of all, when you deployed the cube for the project, it landed up in the multi-dimensional database. Am I right? So you wipe it out from there. Agree? Second place where you do it is what? You created a folder under whatever parent folder you picked, am I right? You want to wipe out that folder and subfolder, am I right?
Yeah.
Those are the two main areas. If you delete them, you have removed the trace. But I also recommend that go to start page and remove the link, because otherwise that link is not valid. And it will interfere. So let me show these things to you, okay? This kind of knowledge is important from test perspective also. Now watch here, guys. If I go to the how do I go to the database? And guys, I'm not talking about relational database at this point. That is the source data. And when I say analysis database, I mean multi-dimensional database.
Yeah.
And if I don't use the word source data, that is what I mean, okay? So how do I go to database?
SQL, Microsoft SQL Management.
Management Server, am I right?
Yeah.
Management Studio? And where do I go now?
Analyze the services.
I want to show you, this is important to understand, because this, you may want to wipe out things when you mess things up. For test perspective, please remember one thing. If you mess a dimension, don't try to fight too much with it. If you can find the solution quickly through the error, good. Otherwise, just delete it and recreate it. The dimension that I'm going to ask you to create in the test, I did this at home today. It took me about 15 minutes. I'm going to give you 1 hour, okay? And I'm going to show you how to do it today. So those of you who are absent today, please share it with your friends. I cannot keep on postponing these things, because in every class, somebody or the other is out. So if I wait for somebody, everybody to be here, it will never happen, okay? So what do I do, analysis services?
Yeah.
Connect? And if I go to database, do you see this thing? This is the result of deployment. So I delete this, okay? That is step number one, to clean things out. Now, what is the other thing I need to do? I need to go to my folder where I have created this stuff. Okay? It was under class, am I right? It was under project.
Yeah.
Let's say it was chapter 3. Let's just assume. So I go to chapter 3. It was probably chapter 5, but I don't want to remove it in case I need it. But they all have the same name anyway, Adventure Works. So if it was 3, I'll just delete chapter 3, and it, don't forget there's subfolders also. Okay? Now, this is the data source. Hello.
Hi. Please. Can I interrupt now,
please,
or is it a good time?
Please. Yeah, just talking.
Okay, because I don't want you guys to forget what you just heard.
Okay. Yeah, just talking general stuff.
Okay.
I was expecting and waiting for you.
Okay, very good.
I'm going to
get out of the spotlight. That's
all.
I would like to know, by the way, is the floor tilted in some way that everybody is over this way, or is it just because of the computer?
No, because of the computers.
Everybody get emails from me? I just found somebody that doesn't get emails from me. Do I bother everybody enough with my emails? Okay? Anybody need any help with resumes or cover letters or interviewing practicing? That's what we're here for. I have somebody coming in Monday morning to practice an interview. We video, she's coming in, we're going to video her. She'll have a file, she'll be able to see how it worked, how it didn't work. And even you guys that are in the lab, you won't just run upstairs to perform and say, take care. You can come across and you can do that in the morning as well. I'm here for a different reason. 2 weeks from tonight, somebody gets a night off. Why? Because there's no class 2 weeks from tonight. Election day. You're not off from class because of election day.
It's off for me.
Okay. You're off because of election day. Everybody else is encouraged and invited to come to career night. We have an event. It is not in this building. It is over at 507th Avenue, between 37th and 38th Street. Just about every subway line runs around that area. So you cannot get lost getting there if you want to get there. You should have gotten last week a save the date email from me. And provided it didn't go to your spam and you didn't bother looking at it, you should have seen it. If you did not get a save the date, send me an email. I'll send it to you again. I want to send that to everybody. There will be an email coming out that will allow you to register for that event. We're having a person come in. She is a professional speech coach. She teaches people how to present themselves. And whether you are from the United States or you're from some other country, the information that she has for you will be extremely valuable. She has been on television, she's spoken at universities, she's spoken at companies, she is entertaining, she's dynamic, she's informative. It is worth your coming to hear her make her presentation. There's a light dinner and registration between 5:30 and 6. 6 o'clock, the dean will say a few words. You'll also be introduced to somebody from the Touro College Graduate School Writing Center. Anybody know about the Writing Center?
Okay. Yes, I know.
Armando knows. We have a group of people. They're in the 43 building here on 23rd Street, who help individuals, could be resumes and cover letters and things of that nature, But if you have to write papers, if you have to create presentations, and they're also helping with verbal communication as well. All you do is you go and you see them once, and then all the other correspondence and communications is through the computer, so you don't even have to go there. Have you taken advantage of it? So that, somebody will be talking about that as well. And then Jane will get up and she'll speak, and she will make a presentation. I'm going to finish with one story. Over 30 some odd years ago, 35 years ago at that time, I was running technology for a division of the Coca-Cola company, which Coke today does not own. It was an entertainment company, and today it's owned by Sony. My team had developed a whole new system for the marketing and sales wing for the motion picture division. And we were going to launch this new system for them so that they could schedule which movie theaters movies were being shown in across the world, record box office results because we were getting information that was coming into us, do analysis on that information to determine how long a movie should run, should be kept over for another week. There were a lot of things that the system did. And the IT department that I was working in came up with a very clever presentation that I was going to make. I was one of the keynote speakers at this presentation. I had an office in New York City, up on Fifth Avenue. I had an office in Burbank, California, because a lot of the entertainment was in Burbank, California. And I was shuttling back and forth. I was out there every third week. And this conference was taking place in Tucson, Arizona. I was scheduled to speak on Wednesday morning at the conference. So I decided I'm going to fly to California, spend Monday and Tuesday in my office in Burbank, work in Burbank, Tuesday night, fly down to Tucson, Arizona. And I informed the people that were running the conference that was my schedule. And they said, you're scheduled to speak on Wednesday morning. I said, yes, that's why I'm flying in on Tuesday night. And they said, no, you're not flying in on Tuesday night, you're flying in on Monday night. I said, but if I'm speaking on Wednesday, why do I have to fly in Monday night? Because you are going to be working with a speech coach for the entire Tuesday. And that's exactly what I did. I had a speech coach from a company called Speakeasy who worked with me. I made my presentation, and she ripped me to pieces and taught me what I needed to do and sent me back to my room for an hour to practice with a mirror, because it's one of the tricks that she taught me. And then I came back to her, and then I went, sent back to my room again. You know, it's like sent to the principal's office. And I practiced other things, and then the next time I met with a different coach whom I had not met before. And that person pointed out other things. I spent the entire day practicing and working with the speech coach, and it taught me an awful lot. And I use some of this when we do practice interviewing as well. In order to emphasize your point, how to talk to an audience, how to present yourself, the tone of your voice, what you do with your hands, what you do with your body, all of those types of things. Jane will be presenting some of that as well, because her concern, which is a very important one, is that when you go out to the business world and you're looking for a job, you may be the greatest person from a technology perspective, but if you don't wow that person in your interpersonal connectivity, in your communications, nobody's going to hire you. That's a known fact. Talk to any CIO and they will tell you they expect you to know your technology code. But they also need for you to be able to interact. And especially if you're an international student, you've got to overcome that fear. You're good at it, you've got to be able to sell yourself. Anybody's ever gone to a salesperson in a car dealership? Anybody ever go to a car dealership? If you ever go there, those people are the most aggressive salespeople. And people invariably wind up spending more on the car than they ever thought that they were going to. Because this salesperson was able to convince you of how important this additional thing in the car is. You've got to have this. And once you're there, they've got you cornered, so they work at you. Well, in a similar vein, you are selling a Rolls Royce. That Rolls Royce is yourself. You have a lot to sell. You've got to have the confidence to sell it, but you have to have the wherewithal to know how to do that. And so this program that we're having will open up your eyes to some of the things that you need to do and some of the things you definitely should not do. Please take advantage of it. 2 weeks from tonight, 5:30, 500 7th Avenue between 37th and 38th Street. Okay? Anybody who doesn't get an email about it, please write to me and say, I'm not giving up. That's my story, and I'm available to help anybody at any time. Otherwise, have a great night, everybody.
Thank you.
Thank you very much. Instructors are we're more than happy to have you come as well.
Thank you.
But enjoy your week.
I can enjoy the time off.
Yeah, that's right. Have a good night.
Trust me, I had a lot of time off. Tuesday, not that much.
I know that. So I see that. Very good.
Thank you.
Have a good night, everybody.
Have a good night.
Let me share one more thing with you guys that I've learned in 65 years. Getting job, working is fine. But if you really want to rise 10 years, 15 years later from that point onwards, the most important single skill is communication. Okay? We foreigners have a problem there. We try to neglect it. Why do I need to be good in communication? I learn technology. I know technology. But even communicating technology is a skill, guys. Let me tell you. Learn that. Don't ever let. You don't have to do it tomorrow or day after. You can do it after you have a job, after you have settled in a job, 5 years, 10 years. But otherwise, you will never go that high. Keep that in mind. Anyway, so what is this? This is view, am I right? This is user default user settings. There are classes in effective communication in this country that you can take. Most companies will offer you those classes. Don't think you know it. Take those classes when you have a chance. Okay, guys, let's move now. Please share what I'm teaching you today. Okay? This is your midterm and final. So anyway, let's delete this. So which folders do I delete?
Chapter 3,
that was the project, okay? And that takes care of your project and its associated files. But I also recommend cleaning up something else. And that is when you go to this data tools, you go to view, start page, view start page. You are not deleting anything here, okay? Keep that in mind. You are just remove. This is just a link. So you are not really deleting anything here but link. So right click and remove the link. That is remove from list. And that is the way to clean up. I'll show it again later on. Now I have given you. All of you should have these files. Please check it. Go to your. Now, what I'm showing you, as I told you, is your final exam and midterm. And you are going to keep a copy of it and help each other learn about it. Basically, I'm giving you away the exam, okay? But of course, there will be some knowledge that will be required. So I want to upload 3 databases. One of them is this, Northwind. So go to Northwind, copy these 2 files, okay? Go to Northwind, and where do I want to place them? Don't want to mess with the original. So right click and copy in the DB, okay, copy. But we already have that. So go there, and copy that, and we should have that.
Where is north wind?
So we already have, under DB, all of you have north wind, am I right?
Under 2000, SQL 2000.
SQL 2000?
You have to go to.
Go to the.
03. Go in there. Go in there.
No, go there, MS 2000.
Now, do you also have order?
Yeah.
Now go, do me another favor, if you don't have it, just copy it, I have it, but you may not so copy it into DB. Now, do me another favor, go back to your converted, okay? And do you have these two exam files? These are databases, okay? Copy them also on DB. Go here, copy it, and if you have it, fine, but you should not have it. And copy this one too.
Based on the 2000.
Okay? I have it because I copied it before. Here. Now, where is the other one?
Modified crystal.
Wait a minute, there is a problem here. Yes, I have it copied. Now, let's go to another one.
Go slow. They don't have the file yet.
Wait. Order processing file, do you see that?
We didn't find the exam.
It
okay.
should be under.
Yeah.
If you go to C drive.
Maybe they.
If you go to C drive,
all of them.
All of them.
Go to MSIN 627
here.
And go to
this first and then also here.
Databases converted. Do you see that?
Yeah.
Do you all see that?
Yes.
There are three folders: SQL 2000, sample, and modified. Those have those files. Okay.
Just
you need to copy. Don't move. Copy.
No, we don't have it.
We will get it if you don't like.
What
the modified and sample.
Could you help them?
I'm coming. I'll help you first.
Guys, help each other, please.
So there is the exam file also.
No, you should have. Do you all have that?
Yes.
Yeah, help each other, please. Now copy these files also.
I need to copy this file.
No, you need to go to his folder first. USB, HQ, which one is it? USB.
E.
E, yeah. Go to 27. And go to.
That's three.
Yeah. And the top.
Two. All of you should have
modified
these.
Modified ensemble?
All of you should have. Besides this, you should have these.
Go in your.
Six files also.
Here and you can put it on the.
Kuspa has placed them on your machine. Find them and copy them, don't
you
move them.
It on the SQL
because you, have to, you don't have it?
No.
Yes. And she will give it
to you. There is a folder under the MSIN 2000. There is a folder.
It should be.
These two folders are
okay.
The database?
Yeah.
All of you copy it, please. If you don't have it, Kuspa will give it to you. Okay, the first thing, guys, the first thing about designing Cube is knowing your data, okay? And that is why I'm giving you exam and order processing. One of these will be midterm, one of these will be final, okay? And the reason I'm giving you these two databases is so you can look at it, use them to practice it, and get familiar with the data, okay? Clear?
North wind and what other?
North wind we are going to do today, okay?
Okay.
This is what we are going to do today. And in your midterm and final, it will be either this or that. Both of these will be there. One will be midterm, one will be final. And they are very, very similar. I'm going to show it to you.
We need to attach a Northwind database, Professor?
We are going to do that. Let's wait. Let's all come together.
Just to copy.
Right now, just copy it into DB folder.
And we need also to copy exam.
Copy all of them.
Exam.
In your DB folder, you should have this. This is in your DB folder, you should have this. Please copy them.
Order processing and exam.
All of these should be there.
Order processing.
Now please help your friends who are out today. Work with them, please.
Okay? And I think so.
Your midterm exam is 20 points. 10 points will be designing the cube, which I'm going to teach you today. You already know it. If you have really learned well chapter 3, 4, 5, they are much more complicated than what I'm going to give you. They are 10 times more complicated than what I'm giving you. So you should not have a problem if you have learned those well. But I'll still show it to you again. Okay? 10 points will be true false. 20 questions. That is part A or part B. And the other part is designing the cube. I did that myself this morning at home. It took me 15 minutes. I'm going to give you half an hour for multiple choice and 1 hour for cube design. Okay? And if you have learned it well, it should not take you more than half an hour. Now, on multiple choice, please understand, your second quiz is on 14th of November. I have postponed your midterm to 28th of November. Originally, it was scheduled for 14th, but I don't want to do both exams at the same time. So midterm will be 28th. Okay? And I will show everything to you, practice it,
28,
and learn it. These are extremely valuable skills. And I will also teach you, I'm not going to give you anything advanced that is beyond you. I am also going to teach you how to do this work in Excel. It is so simple, so easy. Anyway, do you all have that now? Okay, so I'm going to attach these databases. That is the first thing you have to do. The database has to be attached. So I'm going to attach all three of them. The other two databases, figure that out at home, okay? Now, not analysis services, I have to go to database engine, okay? Database engine. What? Same thing you can, but you confuse, you just use Northwind. Database, attach, don't use Northwind new. Just attach Northwind. And you can attach one at a time, but now in the new system you can also attach multiple at a time. Northwind, exam,
and order processing.
And order processing. Now this is something new, okay? In the old system you can only attach one at a time, but you can do that thing today also. Now, on your own, get yourself familiar with the exam and order processing. They are very, very similar, okay? We are going to do Northwind, okay? Now this is a transactional system. In real life, you do not design cubes against transactional systems. But the good news is, you can do it if you want. And most companies, even if they are large companies, salespeople never follow the rules. If they learn a technology, they will do it. We have a reporting system at Pepsi. Crystal, I'm expert in that. And salespeople abuse it left and right. They use Crystal Report Designer to design reports and export them to Excel instead of writing the query. Report is not for exporting to Excel. Report is for reports. But people do it all the time and you can't stop them. Same thing happens. You can design, in today's world, you can design cubes against transactional systems even though it is not done, because it will slow down your transactional system. Salespeople don't care. You should design cubes against warehouses, like what we are doing in SSAS. This is a warehouse, okay? Anyway, now watch here, guys. Please pay attention. If you look at Northwind tables, Now, do you see how many tables are there?
Yeah.
It's a transactional system. Do you see all the tables there? I am not going to use all these tables for the queue. Okay? I can. In final exam, I'll use more tables. But in midterm, I'll use only 4 tables. Okay? Out of these, I'll use only 4 tables. Can you tell me what are those tables? Guess it.
Employee?
No, I won't use employee. That's more complicated.
Oh, yeah?
Employee has self-reference. Do you remember that parent-child?
Yeah.
Yeah.
That may be in the final, by the way. But it won't be in the midterm, okay?
Okay, order?
Let's start with dimension tables first. I want 2 dimension tables.
Product.
Which one those will be?
Product.
Product and customer, okay?
Yeah.
Product and customer.
Clear? I want to ask you to do only 2 dimensions, product and customer. And there will be a 3rd dimension, that will be date. And there is no date here. Do you see that? So I'm going to teach you how to create a date dimension. And I'm not going to expect you to create a date dimension, probably in the test. Okay? But I'll teach you how to anyway. So there will be 3 dimensions. Date dimension is missing. I'm going to show you how to. Now, measures come from sales, am I right?
Yeah.
So I'm going to have only 1 measure for your test. That will be sales amount. Okay? Okay, guys? And to do that, in this case, I have to use these 2 tables. In some situations, you might have only 1 table that contains all the necessary information. But in transactional systems, it is very likely that you might have 2 tables containing the information. Okay?
Yeah.
So let me start now. Are you all together with me?
Yeah.
Guys, please pay attention if you don't
understand. Can you go a little
slow? Okay. Are you all with me now? If you don't understand, I will also show you how to start all over from scratch. So you can, and please work together with your friends to figure it out.
Are you good?
Yeah, I'm good.
This carries 50% of your midterm exam question.
Yeah.
Okay?
Right?
Yeah.
You did too, right?
Yes, ma'am.
I need for all of you to be able to design simple cubes once you get out of this class. And you may not appreciate and understand the value of this, but in real life, this is more important than anything you can think of. Every company can use it. I have a friend with a small company in Long Island. He's a friend of mine. He has a small company. And I showed it to him the other day, and he was so excited, he was willing to pay me. He said, this is something that I really, really needed. Well, I don't get into those things anymore. It is too much of a headache. Anyway, guys, are you all together now? So first thing, I'm going to teach you how to design the date dimension. And this will not be in your test. But you need to know it, because most transactional systems do not have date dimension. Okay? For date dimension, you want the start date and the end date, am I right? And our granularity will be every day, not minute or second. In Wall Street, stock analysis could be minute or second. But in other traditional industries, it is day. So I need to figure out, in my data, what is the earliest date and what is the latest date.
Yeah.
Okay? So let's do that. I run a new query, okay? And this is not going to be in your test, so it is good to know it. Select
mean date.
What is going on here? can't type. Pushpa, I can't type here. We need to get somebody.
Let me check your keyboard, please.
Okay, guys, I know what to do here. Pushpa, can you call somebody, please? Oh, you are here. I forgot. Keyboard connection is a problem, it looks like. Okay, guys, do me a favor. Type select space mint in bracket. Now, order date.
Select
space mint order date.
From orders.
From?
Orders.
Orders. I know the date, so you know, I've done all of this before I came to the class.
Order date.
Select. What is the date field in the order table? Look at it. What is it? Order date or order dates?
Order date.
So do select space mint in bracket order date from orders table. And tell me what is it?
It's for
what is
August 4th. August 4th.
Is it working now?
It's June 4th, 1996.
What is the order? What is the date you got? Minimum date. In real life, guys, you will be probably analyzing data for current data or last couple of years data. Okay, but here we have older databases with older dates.
1996,
July something,
yes.
Am I right?
Yes.
Now do the same thing. Instead of mint type max. And what is that date?
98?
May 98? Okay? So now basically this company has the data between July 96 and May 98. Now instead of worrying about exact dates, what I'm going to do is I'm going to take January 96 to December 98. Of course, there will be no data before July and after May, okay? But that's what I'm going to do, okay? Are you all with me?
Yeah. Usually we need to start with dimension date, Professor. Usually we need to start with dimension date when you plan to design a cube.
You'll do that, you'll see it. First, we need to find the date, am I right?
Mm-hmm.
And then I'll walk you through the steps. Let's get it working. Okay, guys. Now, it is really a very, very useful feature how to design the date dimension. You can do it using data tools, okay? And by the way, you can do a query also. If you have taken 616, if you have taken the course 616, there is a query that is probably not covered in that course, but you can find that query in the books, or you can Google it, and you can run a query to create a table with start date and every day thereafter up to the end date. But query is more complicated, and this is very user-friendly, okay?
Can we use this query in midterm? Can we use...
You don't need to use it. I will give you the data.
Okay.
Okay? What? Is it working? It helps to have a tech here in the room. You don't have to worry about tracking down people. Okay, guys, while we are waiting, let me explain these things. In your final exam, you have what, 45 points, am I right?
Yeah.
You have 45 points? So 20 points will be a cube, and it will be more complicated than midterm. Just few additional features in final, okay? And for 25 points will be true false, so there will be probably 50 true false questions. Now, one more thing. What happened? It's coming, it's probably taking time. Let's use the time while we are trying to figure these things out. Life is never perfect, guys. These problems are not uncommon in life. I run into them all the time. I'm going to ask you some questions, okay? These are typical test type of questions. I'm asking some questions. If it is working, let me know. Usually, where does the dimensions come from?
Dimensions.
What is the source of dimensions? Beam tables, am I right?
Yeah.
And in transactional systems, the word beam may not be there. Like you saw in Northwind, there's a customer, but it is not beam customer. That convention is generally used in OLAP databases. Okay?
Dimensions come from dimension.
From the master tables.
Yeah.
Like product. Now, typically in warehouse it might be called BIM product, but in transactional system it will be called product. Is it working now? Okay? Okay, another question. Measures.
Measures come from?
Measures. Each fact table. Creates a measure group, am I right?
Yeah.
And in that measure group, the numbers that we are interested in summarizing, are the measures, am I right? So if you have three fact table, three measure groups will be created, am I right? If you want all of them. Agreed?
Yeah.
And each measure has to have a unique name. It does not matter which group it belongs to, am I right? Guys, am I right?
Yes.
These are true false type of questions. Okay? Agree? Now, all the measures that we have been dealing with right now are summation measures, am I right? Agree? So you will see something else in chapter 6 that we are going to do. Creating advanced measures. Okay? And let me talk about it a little bit more. All the measures that we talked about so far are summation measures. Meaning we are calculating total of sales. And summation measures means you have a tree in dimension, am I right? You can take any dimension and it has attributes, am I right? And you can sum them up to get the parent. Like total of sales from the quarter is sales, sum of the sales for each month. Sum of sales for each month is sum of sales for each day, am I right? Sum of sales for each city is equal to the sum of sales for the country, am I right? Agreed?
Yeah.
So for every dimension, summation type of measures, you can just add them up. They are the total of the children, am I right? There are other types of measures too that you will see. Can you name some of them? There are three categories of measures. Additive, semi-additive, non-additive. And that is coming in chapter 6. Is it working now? Additive measures means you can calculate the total of the parent by totaling the children for each and every dimension. Okay? Clear? Semi-additive means you can calculate the total of the parent by totaling the children except for the date dimension. Let me give you an example. Inventory. Can you calculate the inventory at the end of a month by totaling the inventory of every day?
No.
Can you calculate the inventory at the end of a quarter by totaling the inventory at the end of every quarter?
No.
Okay? So across time dimension, you cannot sum it up. Got it? But if you have 20 warehouses, can you calculate the inventory at the end of the quarter by summing the inventory from 20 warehouses at the end of the quarter?
Yeah.
You can, am I right? So semi-additive means you can calculate by adding except in the time dimension. Got it?
Yeah.
Clear?
Clear.
How about non-additive? You cannot calculate.
It's simple.
By
life.
Adding across any dimension.
Percentage of cells.
Let me tell you. Percentage of cells. Percentage of cells has to be calculated for each and every. You cannot just add them up. Am I right? Distinct count of customers. Now, distinct count of customers who bought an order, who bought an item at the end of the quarter is not the same as adding every month, am I right? It cannot be added at all. Those are non-additive. The book talks about something else. It is, I don't know the word that they are using. I think it is called pseudo-additive, but Microsoft doesn't use that word, okay? What the book says, like min and max, max order quantity for a quarter at the end of the quarter is the max order quantity for each of the 3 months, am I right? Okay?
Yeah.
So it's one of the children. You don't add it, but it is one of the children, okay? Okay? So those things are chapter 6. I suggest start studying it, it will be helpful. Okay? Okay, so I'm going to teach you now how to, we have the dates, July 96 to May 98. Now, I will not go by July to May, I will go by January to December, okay? And we will get zero sales before and after, doesn't matter. So now the idea is how to design the date or time dimension, okay? Now the simplest, if you are an SQL expert, you can use SQL to do it, but I'll show you a simple way to do it, okay? There is another way to do it also, by the way. You can take Microsoft Excel and have a date for every day and then just bring it in. That's another simple way, but I'll show you something else, okay? All of you follow along with me. I'm going to go slow, okay? Because this is your exam. Now, first thing I have to do is, I have to create a project.
Yeah.
Please, I'm going to go slow, follow along with me. So let's create a project.
File.
So can you fix this because it's new project, okay? Now, all of you, do me a favor. Do you all have C:\class?
Yeah.
Do you all have that?
Yeah.
If not, create it. Create a class folder.
Yeah.
Stay with me, please.
Okay.
If you create it because it's better to stay with me than do something different, then you'll get confused. And I want to create a project called, use your name, please, don't use my name. Use your name. I'm going to use my name, okay? Your first name. Now stay with me, that's what my advice is. If you don't have a folder called underscore class, create one. Yeah, it is going too far here. It is going up and down. See, I don't want to go up and down. I think control F will do it. Wait. I am showing it to my class. Do you all have that?
Yeah.
Did you use your name? Don't use my name. I'm going to use this project actually, but I will also use this project to create the data. Okay? Click OK. And we have a new project. Now, what is the first thing we do?
We need to create data source.
We define data source, am I right?
Yeah.
New data source? Agreed?
Yeah.
Are you with me? Are you all with me? New data source. Guys, if you are behind here, we are almost in the middle of the semester. You need to practice, you need to work. My goal is not to give less than B to anybody, but I will not hesitate to do that if I find that you are screwing up completely. Are you all with me? First of all, better like this, don't need this. Secondly, can you create a project? For some reason, we have not created it. If you have already created, then you just open that. File, open. Where is it?
We have to attach it to Northwind.
Yeah.
You created a project, not a service. That's all right. Okay? Are you all with me now?
Yeah.
Is he ready, Pushpa? Are you guys all good? Guys, this should be your second nature by now. Okay, so go on next. And do you see Northwind is not there? If it is not there, you have to create new, am I right?
Yeah.
You have to create new connection. So click on new. Now, guys, conventionally, data source name, we keep the same as the name of the database, okay? If it is Northwind, we'll call it Northwind. If it is exam, we'll call it exam. If it is inventory system, we'll call it inventory system. So we'll use the standard name, okay? Now, always use the service account for this class, okay?
You have to go further back.
Yeah. You say to click new
and now.
To click next.
Yeah.
Okay.
Okay, I have to click new.
Yes.
Okay?
Yeah.
Now server name, if you are using your own laptop, your machine name might be different, you might be using that. But here, those of you who are using the class machine, we can use it localhost. Okay? But those of you who are using your laptop, it might be your machine name. Okay? And now we use the database. Which database is it?
Northwind.
Northwind?
Yeah.
Always test the connection. Because if you cannot connect to the data source, nothing will work. So always check it, okay? Are you with me? Are you all with me?
Yeah.
Click on OK. And click on OK. And now we have created Northwind. Okay? Now if you are using your laptop, you may have to use your computer name. Now click on Next. And always use service account, please. Okay? Because otherwise things will become different. I don't want that. Click on Next. Don't use specific account, use service account. Next. And data source name, by convention, we keep the same as the name of the database. So please follow that convention for the classroom. You don't have to, but we follow that. Okay? Click on Finish, and we are done. Okay? Are you all with me? The cube I'm going to design will be very, very simple. There will be just a few attributes for a few dimensions, that's it. Okay? Because you don't want to spend 2 hours fighting with the cube in the exam. So next thing we do is data source view. New data source view. Are you with me? Next. And it will be based on Northwind, okay?
Yeah.
Are you with me? Yeah. By the way, if you did not follow the previous step, you can create a new data source here also. I did it earlier, but you could do it here too. We already have it, so next.
You choose.
Okay, now, guys, now wait here, okay? I'm going to, for now, I'm going to take only one table, for now, okay? So that table will be product table. Or let's take product table, next. Here. We will add other tables later on. View can always be modified later on, okay?
Yeah.
So right now I'm taking only one, just to stay focused. Click on Next, and we will use the same name, okay? This is the convention you need. You use the same name for view as well as for database, so we are done. Okay, guys?
Okay.
Are you with me?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Now, see, to create dimension, I need this. This is not the only way. If you know SQL, you can go to your relational database, write the SQL to create a table for every day between January 1st to 1996 and December 31st for every day. The other thing is you can create a table in Excel and import it, or use Excel directly. There are a number of ways of doing it. Now what I'm going to do is this, guys. I'm going to create a dimension here, okay? Other dimensions I'm going to create later on, but let me show you how to create time dimension. Right click, new dimension, okay? Are you all with me?
Yes, sir.
This is not going to be in your test, but you must learn this. Next. Now, this is important. We do not have any existing table for time dimension, am I right?
Yeah.
For date. So what do I pick here? There are multiple choices. This means you create the table on the server. On the server means what? It will be created on analysis server, multi-dimensional. And this will create in the source. Northwind. Okay? I want to create it in the source so you have it. So I'm going to say generate the table on the source. Are you with me? Are you all with me?
Yes, sir.
Because that way it will create the table in Northwind in the source. Next. Now it is asking me what dates. And that is why I asked you minimum and maximum.
Yeah.
Of course you want to include all the date, but I want to stay December to January to December. Okay? So here I'm going to use 1996, am I right? And here I will use 1998. I'm going to go slow here, okay? Are you with me? These are the dates in our sales table, am I right?
Yeah.
I mean, everything is within these dates. I have extra dates, but I want to stay consistent with calendar year. Are you with me? Now, I want to pick year, I want to pick quarter, I want to pick month, and I want to pick date. I don't care about week. Some companies might analyze by week or by half year, but I'll stick to
year, quarter,
year, quarter, and month.
Month and
date is already there.
Okay.
Okay?
Four. Yeah.
See, we want to work with day, date. Day is the date. Month, quarter, and year. Okay? Are you with me? Next. And we just want one calendar, that's it. In chapter 5, we did fiscal calendar also. If you do fiscal calendar, it will ask you what are the dates for fiscal calendar. Is it April 1st or is it July 1st? We won't do it. I will keep it simple for you. Okay? So we'll just do regular calendar. Next. And you see it tells us that it will pick these attributes. Okay? Are you with me?
Yeah.
I'm going to say generate schema now.
Name is date, time, or we need to put date in the
name? No, just leave it as is.
Okay.
Okay? You can change the date to time, but I'll leave it as is so that you don't get confused. You can change it to date if you want, but I'll leave it. And generate the schema now, finish. Now it is going to generate the schema, next. And we are going to use it in the existing view, Northwind. You can create a new view, but we want to use the existing view. We already have the view, we want it inside that view. Okay?
Okay.
Now practice it a few times. You can delete the dimension, create it again, practice it. Okay? Next. And I'll just leave it as is. I'll populate and everything. Next. Next. Finish. And now watch what happens. And guys, again, if you want to get familiar with this, create the time dimension, delete it, recreate it, delete it, recreate it a few times. If you want to delete it, you have to delete it here, and here you go to Northwind database, and there will be a table called time, and you have to delete that too, okay? Is it finished? Committing changes to subject database. It is putting it into transactional system, okay? It's going to take a little time.
Committed.
Yeah.
Is it committing?
No, but down it says submission.
Generate completely successful.
As it's, when it says, yeah, it is a misnomer here, guys. It is done. Okay? When you see close, that means it is done. And now we have a time dimension. Do you see that? Now this dimension is coming from a table called time that we created. Okay? Let me show that to you. Watch. Now what you can do, guys, if you want to practice it, even though it will not, I'm going to save it, okay? I'm going to save this. But if you want to practice it, you can delete it here, and you can go to your relational database and delete it there and do it again. So far, nothing is in the multi-dimensional view. Let me show it to you, it is there, okay? Do you see you have time? You can call it date, but I have left it at time so that there's less confusion. You can always rename things. Okay? So if you want to practice it a few times, delete this guy and delete the dimension and recreate it.
It also make a lesson in another place.
I'm coming to that. Let's take one step at a time. All those things are coming up. Okay, now let's go back. We have a time dimension, okay? And we have a data source view. Okay? This is our data source view. Now, where is our time dimension? Here. Product time. What else do I need? There are three dimensions that I will be asking you to do. Time is always there, almost always there in cubes. We created it because we didn't have it. Product we picked. I'm going to pick customer also. Okay?
Yeah.
Guys, this is in the test, so please pay attention. Creating time dimension, I am not going to ask you to do. I'm going to give it to you. Okay? So you don't have to know what I taught you so far. But in real life, it is a good practice to know it. I had a student at NYU, I showed it to that guy, and he forgot it after 1 year, and he contacts me. Can you help me how to create it? Okay? It's a matter of practice, guys. Now I need one more table here. Add remove table. And which table do I want here?
Customers.
Okay? I'm not yet done, guys. We are going to have a star schema. In a star schema, you have a sales table, am I right?
Yeah.
Agreed?
Yeah.
And all these tables, master tables or dimension tables,
are related to one
to
many.
The sales table, am I right?
Yeah.
So I need the sales table now. Okay, guys?
Yes.
So let me show you how to get the sales table. Let me show it to you. I'm going to go back to my database. Now I may give you a sales table, I may ask you to create it because you have to know it. This is something that you have learned. Database. I want sales amount. I just want one measure sales amount. Now where will sales amount come from?
From the data sets.
You have orders table. Do you see that?
Yeah.
Now, orders table has which columns? Order ID, customer ID, and you have two IDs. Do you see that?
Yeah.
In orders table, every order has a unique ID, am I right? Agreed?
Yeah.
So you can get these two from here. Where will you get the sales amount from?
Order details.
Order details. Order details as what? Order ID links to the orders, am I right? What is the relationship between orders?
One to many,
am I right? Each order could have many line items. Agreed?
Yeah.
So they are linked on order ID. And we have product ID here, am I right?
Yeah.
And where do I get the sales amount?
From the order details.
Unit price and quantity.
I will not use discount, I will not use anything else. I will just use a simple summation, okay? So I need these two tables to create my sales fact table, okay?
We need to create a view here, Professor, or not?
I'm going to show it. Now I go back. So guys, tell me, what is a simple way to do it? There are multiple ways of doing it. One is, in the relational database, you can create a view, okay? You can create a view of necessary fields. That's
you can calculate.
And then add that view here. View is like a table, okay?
Yeah.
I'm going to do it this way, watch. Now, my suggestion is practice both ways, but this is what I'm going to do, named query. Do you see named query?
Yeah.
this is just one way of doing it. It is the same thing as creating view, okay? I'm going to call it sales. And description will be sales. Okay? Clear?
Yeah. Now we need to create.
I will add orders.
Order and order details.
And I will add order details. And because of the relationship, they are should
order.
Be automatically joined.
Order
do you
and
see
order
that?
Details.
How do I add that?
Can you repeat this?
You go here, this is called add tables, and pick whatever tables you need.
How did we get to this screen?
Which screen?
This screen?
This screen was, I'm going to try all over again. You can create a view also, but I'm going to add it directly here. New named query.
New named query.
Okay? Please, in your test, do not do view. Do it this way, the way I'm showing it to you. Okay? If you do view, I may not deduct your point, but follow what I'm showing you. It will be easier for me to grade. And it will be easier for you to follow along. So I say new query, and let's call this query sales. Sales. Okay?
Yeah.
And which tables I need?
Order and order details.
Now understand, guys, one thing. I have given you two databases, one will be in final, one will be in midterm, I haven't decided which one, but one of them has order details and orders, another doesn't have it. Orders has everything in it. Okay? So it could be a little different. Are you with me?
Yeah.
Now I need this field, and from here I need customer ID, okay? And I need order date. Okay? Date will link to the time field. Customer ID will link to customer dimension. Date will link to date dimension, which is time here. Okay? Are you with me?
Yeah.
And where do I get product ID? From here. And I'm going to keep things simple, guys. If you did chapter 5 really well, it's much more complicated. It brought in price, if you remember, and then it hid it from browsing. I'm not going to do any of that. I'm going to just calculate sales amount by multiplying these two. Okay? Are you with me? And let me show you what is the easy way to do it. This is what I do. I select both of these, and they appear here. Watch. They are here. Do you see that? Do you see that?
Yes.
So I will do this. Order unit price, and I'll change it to multiplied by. What is multiplied by? Pound sign? Yeah, sorry. Star, am I right? And now what do I do, guys? You know these things. 15 and 16. As sales amount. Do you understand this query?
Yeah.
Yeah.
It is 615 and 660. I'm keeping things simple, guys. Okay? I need sales amount is going to be my measure. I need only one measure. Okay? Clear? Are you guys with me? As sales amount. Now always check your query. If your query is bad, nothing will work. So execute the query to see if it is giving you the data. If it is giving you the data, you are in good shape. You have sales amount. Now watch here, guys. You are in business now. This will link to customer dimension. This will link to time or date dimension. This will link to product dimension. And this will give you the measure. Do you see that?
Pause
Did you all get it?
Yeah.
Please help each other. I will wait till you all got it. I will take 10 more minutes, we'll complete the view, and then we'll take a break.
Professor, I have a question.
Just 1 second. Your midterm and your final exam is not going to be based on North Wind. Keep that in mind. It will be either on exam or order processing system. Okay? So you can use those and get practice and work with each other.
I don't have battery. Can I save the project now and can I go in? Can I save in flash my project now and to go? I don't have battery.
You
no.
don't have what?
I don't have a lot of battery. Can I save this project and to go in?
Yeah, you can save it, but stay with the class, please.
Okay.
I'm not yet done there, okay?
Okay.
I want to keep everyone together because this is test material. Guys, if you are having difficulty with this, my suggestion is forget about lunch and dinner and figure it out. Okay? Now, once your data is there, you are in business, click OK. And now you have sales table. Do you see that?
Yeah.
Now, tell me something, guys. Tell me something. Guys, there are. This is a primary key. Customer should have a primary key also because it is coming directly, am I right?
Yeah.
It's a primary key, do you see that? Product has a primary key, do you see that?
Yeah.
Sales doesn't have any keys, why? You learned this in chapter 3, 4, 5. Because it
because
is a query. If I could have brought in both tables, order and order details, it would have complicated things. Okay? So instead of bringing them, I have created a named query and called it sales. Now this does not have foreign keys. These are going to be foreign keys, okay? These are going to be foreign keys. Clear?
Yeah.
So how do I define foreign keys here?
Right click.
Guys, it's very simple. Drag from many to one. Remember, many to one, not one to many. So customer ID, drag it to customer ID. Many. This is the many side, am I right? Are you with me? Drag it from here to here. Okay? Clear? Drag from many to one, many to. Now drag this to where?
The product ID.
Okay?
Yeah.
What else?
Date.
See, if you had a table called sales in your data source, it will probably have foreign keys defined there, relationships. But because we took a query, the relationships are not defined. Okay? And in your test, please do not, you will get confused and you will have problems. Do not bring in order and order details. Okay?
Which one is the foreign key for the time table?
Foreign key is always date.
How can you define?
This is the primary key date.
Okay?
Foreign key, this is the primary key, and you have to drag it order date to this. This order date is the sales date. There are other dates, I'm not going to use them. When you created a time dimension in chapter 4, date
order
dimension,
ID.
You had a role playing dimension, you had ship date, you had other request
ID.
Dates, okay?
Order.
I'm keeping things real simple,
order
guys.
Date.
Trust me, once you have done your midterm and final, you will have mastered this. If not, you are not going to get a good grade. And once you have mastered it, you will be thankful. If you don't get it, sit down with your friend, practice it. Are you all with me? Now save your work. click on save and save your work. We are done with the view. So far, we have created one dimension called time, which is really date dimension. You can call it date, but leave it at time. Okay, and we have to create more dimensions, which will be those dimensions. This one and that one, am I right? And then we have to create a measure that will be part of the cube. Measure is not outside the cube. Measure is inside the cube. Dimensions are outside the cube. They are in the database. They can be used in multiple cubes. Okay?
Yeah.
Now in chapter 4, we created dimensions before we created the cube. Am I right?
Yeah.
But I'll show you another way. You can do that, but I'll show you a simpler way. Okay? Are you all with me? Please?
How can you find that base table we need?
Well, I have already told you. You need a sales table, which could be order details. Or if you don't have ordered and order details separately, you should have a table called orders or a sales table, whatever it is. You basically need these items. They could be in two tables or they could be in one table. That's what you need, okay? Clear? Please feel free to ask questions. I don't mind it. I would much rather have you ask me questions now. Okay?
Student
comments. Clear? Got it?
Yeah.
Okay, so view is done. Save your work and give me another 5 minutes and we'll take a break. Now, I already have the time dimension which I needed to create. But guys, I may already give you a timetable. If I give you a timetable, all you have to do is, if you already have a timetable, all you have to do is right-click dimension, new dimension, and pick the timetable, okay? So practice that. Now, there are two ways. You can create other dimensions ahead of time, like you did in chapter 4, or you can do it while you are using the cube designer, step by step, okay? How do you want me to do it? Tell me. How do you want me to do it? I'll do it what you want. Shall I do it ahead of time? It is less confusing.
Yeah.
Let me do it ahead of time. And I want very, very simple time dimension. Those two dimensions. I go to dimension,
new
dimension, which use existing table, am I right?
Yeah.
Which table is it? Products, that is one of them. Product ID is the key, am I right?
Yeah.
And name column will be product name. You know that, am I right? See, what is the relationship between the two? What I'm saying is, my key is product ID, but for executive, they will get confused when you see product ID XYZ. They want to see the name. So they will see the name, they won't see the ID, because these two have one-to-one relationship. Every product has a unique name. Okay?
Yeah.
Clear? And that is all I will use. I am not going to use anything else. Next, I don't want anything else, guys. I want a very, very simple cube. Your book is much more complicated. Okay? I just want one dimension, product name, which is product ID. So I will leave it at, in book you pick other stuff and you do other stuff. That is it. Done. Okay? Let me do one more dimension and we are done. What was that?
Customer,
am I right? Customer, am I right?
Yeah.
And again, customer ID?
Customer
and what
name.
Will I pick?
Customer name.
See how simple I'm making your life? I don't care about... Now, here, guys, I want to make things a little more complicated. Because executive might want to see the sales by city or by country. Okay? They may also want to see by other keys, so I will pick them here. Next.
Sir, by mistake you picked the company name.
Yeah, that's fine.
Yeah, the company name.
Customer ID is company name, that's correct.
Okay, so you know,
I don't want contact name. I want.
Okay.
See, there is one-to-one relationship between company and ID. Okay? Now, for this one, I will make things a little more complicated. And I expect you to do that in the test. Region, this is a global company. So region is really state. But I'll leave that out. I just want, let's pick state also, why not? We'll pick city, state, and country. Okay? Because I, executive may want to see sales by country. They may want to see sales by city.
And
by
sales
state.
By region.
Okay? So I'm going to make it a little more complicated.
There is no state, it's a region.
What?
No state is there, it's a region.
State is called region here.
Okay.
Region is the state because in certain countries like France, they may not call it state. It's a global database. So if you see state, pick state. If you see region, pick region. Okay? Next. And we are done. And save your work. And save your work and let's continue after the break. Okay? 15 minutes, please.